the moment, our counselors are busy helping other callers. After the beep, please leave a detailed message about how street art is affecting your life. You are not alone. There is help.
I always have to take pictures of street art. I will run into the middle of the street. It doesn't matter where I am. It doesn't matter what the traffic is like. If I see something and I like it, I will run towards it, and my friends think I'm going to get run over by a car.
Hi, my name is Brittany Shamus, and I can't stop looking at Instagram because of my street art addiction.
My name is Kalin Hart,
and I'm addicted to street art.
It was a trip. I was in Florida with friends. I was out bar hopping, and I handed my friend my phone. I was like, I'm just going to do a quick handstand. And it was messy, and I think my nipple was showing, and it was a terrible photo. It was pixelated, all of this. But my friends, my followers really enjoyed it, you know, because it was kind of a connection. It was like, okay, I know this artist, this muralist. And then I also, that's my friend Kalin, you know. So it kind of started from there. A lot of times I just try to compliment the work. So if it's a very graphic mural, if there are lots of straight lines, then I'll have my legs straight. If it's a fluid mural with lots of soft lines, I'll have my body arced. Sometimes I try to put my legs, you know, if there's some sort of, you know, whatever it is, like a line or a leg or a part of some image, I'll try to put my body parts so they fit within the mural. And I just like to go with the vibe of the mural. I've found Instagram to be an incredibly powerful platform. It's unlike any other. It's absolutely incredible. I feel like the street art world wouldn't be what it is without this platform because of the connections that we can make. Artist to artist, I've known a lot of great, more kind of wheat pasters and people that go out at night, and they've discovered each other through this platform, and then they link up through DM, and then they're buddies and they're going out pasting. And that connection never would have happened without the platform, which is incredible.
So I just got notified that I was tagged in a post. So, oh, it's from Art Dog NYC, Indigo. So Indigo is a street art dog that goes around and poses in front of street art. Super cute. There he is in front of Kafka. I always love seeing them find my stuff. And this one says, "You're in love with my mystery."
Yo, big up Instagram, thank you, because you know how much pieces I sold out of Instagram? I didn't need no agent, I didn't need no art dealer, I didn't need none of that. I did them by myself.
I feel like I'm seeing all of my friends. Here's our Sock 6. You know, I love it. It's so amazing being friends with artists and then seeing them when they're not here, you know, and you're by yourself, and it's, you know, it's like your buddies, like here's this artist and that artist, and I love the decay, you know, like all of this, when it starts to come apart, it's so sexy, it's so raw. I love it. It's a drug. I love it, street art itself. When you find a new piece, especially when you're alone, there's something about, it's like this, when I'm by myself and I find a new piece, a new wheat paste, a new whatever it may be, I'm addicted to street art. Yeah, absolutely.